See here examples of ring. Example one, the set R consisting of a single element 0 with two binary operations defined by 0 plus 0 is equal to 0 and 0 dot 0 is equal to 0 is a ring. This ring is called the null ring or the zero ring. So this set R, this has only one element, which is 0. So it is our null ring. Example two. The set I of all integers is a ring with respect to addition of integers and multiplication of integers as the two ring compositions. So this ring is called the ring of integers. See here, as in groups, we should first prove that I is an abelian group with respect to addition of integers. First see that the product of two integers is also an integer. No doubt, if we have two integers, 2 into 3, so it will be 6, which is an integer. Or -2 into 3 is -6, which is also an integer. So the product of two integers is also an integer. Therefore, I is closed with respect to multiplication of integers. Second, multiplication of integers is an associative composition. No doubt, it is also true. Third, multiplication of integers is distributive with respect to addition of integers. It means if you have two elements, ABC, then A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. And B plus C into A will be BA plus CA. No doubt it is also true. Therefore, this I is a ring with respect to addition and multiplication of integers. No doubt. We have earlier studied that I is a group, an abelian group with respect to addition. So all the conditions are fulfilled here for I to be a ring. Next, the integer 0 is the zero element of the ring. Also, the multiplicative identity exists and it is the integer 1. We have 1 into 1 is equal to A, this is equal to 1 into 1 for all A in I. Therefore, the ring of integers is a ring with unity. This integer 1 is the unit element of this ring. The multiplication of integers is also a commutative composition. Therefore, this I is a commutative ring. See another example 3. The set 2i of all even integers is a commutative ring without unity, the addition and multiplication of integers being the two ring compositions. Without unity, since it is 2i, so it will not have any unity element. Fourth example, the set Q of all rational numbers is a commutative ring with unity, the addition and multiplication of rational numbers being the two ring compositions. Here unity is the multiplicative identity. See example 5. The set R of all real numbers is a commutative ring with unity. The addition and composition of real numbers being the two ring compositions, it is also true. Second, next example 6, the set C of all complex numbers is also a commutative ring with unity. The addition and multiplication of complex numbers being the two ring compositions. One more example here. This is an important example. Several times it was asked in your examinations. Example 7, the set M of all n by n matrices with their elements as real numbers. Rational numbers, complex numbers or integers also is a non-commutative ring with unity. With respect to addition of matrices and with respect to multiplication of matrices as the two ring composition. So this is our not ordinary sets as our set of real numbers or integers or rationals. This is our set M of all matrices. Matrices of what? Matrices, square type matrices, n by n matrices. So this set M is having all n by n type square matrices. Seed solution. We know that the sum and product of two n by n matrices with their elements as real numbers are again n by n matrices with their elements as real numbers. No doubt, suppose we have two matrices A and B of n by n type and their elements are real numbers, then their product will also be a real number and the sum, their product will also be a matrix of the type n by n and the product will also be a matrix of the type n by n and their elements will be real numbers. So it is true. Therefore, this M is closed with respect to addition and multiplication of matrices. Okay, clear. Further, three matrices ABC are such that A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C for all ABC in M. Since addition of matrices is an associative composition, it is also true. A plus B is equal to B plus A for all AB in M. C since addition of matrices is a commutative composition. If O, this is O not zero, this is O. If O is the null matrix of the type n by n, then O belongs to M. Since it is a square matrix of type n by n, so it is an element of M. And also we have O plus A is equal to A for all A in M. So this O is the null matrix. All its elements are zero. Fourth, to each matrix A in M, there exists a matrix minus A in M, negative of A, such that minus A plus A will be O, null matrix. It is also true. If M contains A, then M will also have minus A. Third, fifth, ABC is equal to A into BC for all ABC. Since multiplication of matrices is associative, see here, A is of n by n type, B is of n by n type, C is of n by n type. So their multiplication is possible. And also ABC is equal to A into BC for all BC and M, since multiplication is associative in matrices. Six, A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, and B plus A is equal to BA plus CA. So matrix multiplication is distributive with respect to matrix addition. So it is also true. Hence, M is a ring with respect to the two given compositions. What two given compositions? Addition of matrices and multiplication of matrices. The null matrix O of the type n by n is the zero element of the of this ring, means it is additive identity. Since the multiplication of matrices is not in general commutative, therefore this ring is a non-commutative ring. So we have proved that this is a ring. The set is a ring, non-commutative ring with unity. Finally, if I be the unit matrix of the type n by n, then I belongs to M, and we have I into A is good A is good A into I for all A in M. This is I. All its diagonal elements are 1 and all non-diagonal elements are 0. Therefore, the matrix I is the multiplicative identity. Thus, the ring M is a ring with unity, and the matrix I is the unity element of the ring. That is, I is equal to 1. So this problem is also proved. There is another example. See a little bit part of here. The set R is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a commutative ring with respect to plus 6 and cross multiplication, say, as the two ring compositions. This is your addition modulo 6 and this is your multiplication modulo 6. What does it mean? See here, there are elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is our multiplication modulo 6. It means multiply this element with this element. So 0 into 0 is 0. Multiply, divide, 0 into 0 will be 0, divide by 6. So the balance will be 0. So it is 0 here. Similarly, 0 into 1 is 0, divide by 6, balance is 0. So it is 0 here. In all cases, it is 0. 1 into 0 is 0, so balance is 0. 1 into 1 is 1, divide by 6, so balance will be 1. So it is 1. Similarly, up to 5. For 2, this is 0, this is 2, this is 4, but this is for this place, 2 into 3 is 6. If you divide by 6, so it will, the balance will be 0, so it is 0 here. So in this way, you can complete this table. Now it is clear from the table that all these elements belong to either of these 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this R is closed with respect to composition. Multiplication modulo 6. Also, this is an associative composition in R. Further, this is distributive in R with respect to plus 6. If ABC are elements of R, then A multiplication modulo 6 is equal to B plus C, B multiplication modulo 6, C. This is equal to A multiplication modulo 6, B plus C. So, no doubt it is very clear. Our main purpose is to see here how this multiplication modulo 6 functions. Okay. So there are, see here, some more topics. Some special types of rings with zero or without zero divisors. We have proved that in any ring, if zero is the additive identity, that is the zero element of the ring, then 0 into A will be A into 0, this is equal to 0 for all A in R. No doubt it is true. However, there are rings in which it is possible that AB is equal to 0 when neither A is 0 nor B is 0. Sometimes it is possible that A into B is 0, but neither A is 0 nor B is 0. Such elements are called zero divisors, since they can divide zeros. So see the definition. A non-zero element of a ring R is called a zero divisor, or a divisor of zero, or an element that divides zero, if there exists an element B not equal to zero in R such that either AB is equal to zero or BA is equal to zero. So here, this is non-zero. This divides B. Next, ring without zero divisors. A ring R in which is without zero divisors, if the product of two non-zero elements of R is zero, that is if AB is equal to zero implies either A is zero or B is zero. So in this case, we will have ring without zero divisors. On the other hand, if in a ring R there exist non-zero elements A and B such that AB is equal to zero, then R is said to be ring with zero divisors. See here one example, it will clear your concept. Suppose M is a ring of all 2x2 matrices with their elements as integers. This M is a ring. This is containing all 2x2 matrices. So it is having square matrices and its elements are integers. So it is clearly it is a ring. The addition and multiplication of matrices being the two ring compositions, then M is a ring with zero divisors. Earlier we have proved that this M will be a ring, but here it is to prove that it is with zero divisors. See here, the null matrix O is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0 is the zero element of the ring, of this ring. It is additive identity. Now A is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1 and B is equal to 0, 0, 1, 0 are two non-zero elements of this ring. That is A is not equal to and B is not equal to. And also AB is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. A multiplication of these two matrices is equal to 0, 0, 0, it is equal to O. See here. AB is equal to 0, but neither A is 0 nor B is 0. AB is equal to 0, so this M is a ring with 0 divisors. See here, AB is equal to 0, but neither A is O nor B is O, but AB is equal to O means null matrix. So this M is a ring with 0 divisors. See also, B into A is equal to 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, it is equal to 0, 0, 1, 0. It is not equal to O. So A into B is equal to null matrix, but B into A is not equal to null matrix. So in a ring, it is possible that AB is equal to 0, but BA is not equal to 0. It is possible for a ring. So I think it is all clear to you, all of you. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me, or see here, there are some more examples. The ring 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 6 multiplication 6 is a ring with 0 divisors. It is your addition modulo 6, it is your multiplication modulo 6 with 0 divisors. See here, 2 multiplication modulo 6, 3 is equal to 0. Since 2 into 3 is equal to 6, if you divide by 6, the multiplication of 2 and 3, we will have remainder 0. So it is a ring with 0 divisor. That is the product of two non-zero elements is equal to the zero element of the ring. This two is non-zero, this three is non-zero, but their product is zero under this composition. So this ring is with zero divisors. Second, the ring of integers is a ring without zero divisors. We have also have some rings of integers, which is without zero divisors. See here, the product of two non-zero integers cannot be equal to the zero integer. Is clear. Next, we come to a theorem. See here, theorem. A ring R is without zero divisors if and only if the cancellation laws hold in R. That is, R is without zero divisors implies and is implied by cancellation laws hold in R. We have studied cancellation laws. See here its solution. First, suppose that R has no zero divisors. Let ABC be any three elements of R such that A is non-zero and AB is equal to AC. Then AB is equal to AC will imply that AB minus AC is equal to zero, so A into B minus C is equal to zero. Since R is without zero divisors, therefore a into b minus c is equal to 0 and a is non-zero, so b minus c will be 0 since r is without zero divisors, so b minus c should be 0, therefore b is equal to c. It means left cancellation law hold in r. It is clear. Similarly, we can show that the right cancellation law also holds in R. Conversely, suppose that the cancellation laws hold in R. If possible, let AB is equal to 0, A non-zero and B non-zero. Then we have AB is equal to A into 0, since A into 0 will be 0. So AB can be written as A into 0. Now A is non-zero and AB is equal to A0, it implies B is equal to 0. By left cancellation law. Since A is non-zero, so we can apply here left cancellation law. So here we get that B is equal to 0. Earlier we assumed that B is non-zero, but now we come to the point that B is equal to 0. Therefore, we get a contradiction. Hence, R is without zero divisors. So this is all about for today. In the next class, we will study about integral domain, field, and some theorems. If you have any query or any doubt, you just ask me your questions here and also prepare your notebook. It will be seen when college opens.